Yes, we are going to see the queue implementation using linked list. So what is meant by queue? As in the normal real world, wherever we go, we stand in a queue. So the person who is coming earlier, he will receive the service first. Then the next person who is standing next to him, and so on till the end. So the one who has come recently will be added at the end of the queue. The one who come earlier will be in the front of the queue. So in which order they have come, that order they will receive the service. The same thing here also. So here this is the let us say this is the queue structure. Here we have this is that we are implementing it using the linked list. You know, a single linked list consists of two fields. One is data field and another one is next field, where it points to the memory location of the next node of the same type. In earlier we have seen the queue implementation using arrays. Now we are going to see using linked list. So let us imagine this is a nodes. This is one node, another node, and so on. They are in a queue. So how you will see that the queue can be operated using two pointers. One is front end, another one is rear. Front points to the front portion and rear points to the end of the queue. So if anything has to be if any new node has to be added, it can be added only at the rear, because at the end of the list only you will allow the entry. So here this is the end of the list. So if any new node has to be added, then you can add only at the end. This is the strict implementation, a strict conception, concept. Then if you are going to remove anything, then you can remove only from the front of the queue. So using this pointer, you can remove. So using this pointer, rear pointer, you can add. You will not remove in between elements. You cannot add anything in between. This is a strict rule of a queue. So here, that is why we call it as a FIFO structure, which is nothing but first in, first out. The one which has entered into the queue first, that will be the one which comes out first. So that is the meaning of this FIFO. Now we'll see how to create a queue. So before that, we will see the structure for queue. So here we create a node. So this is a node, and we declare that is of type struct, where we have data field and any data, string or character or anything, we can place it. So that is why we have used a template. So the next one, it is a node. It is again a pointer, which is of type node type, which is pointing to the next one, which is of the same type. That is why we have declared node. It's like a recursion. Node star next, which is star is for pointer. So the next field is a pointer, which points to the memory location, which have the same type. So now the class we have declared as another class called queue, and within that we are going to create declare two pointers, where front and rear are the pointers which are of type node type. So here we have declared, and then we have declared the constructor queue, where we initially there will be no node. So both the pointers are pointing to null. So which means when the queue is empty, both the front and rear will point to the null. When there is no node, both will be pointing to null. So that is what is meaning. Now is full, we are the member functions which I have declared here is full, is empty. We have to check whether anything has to be added, there has to be some space. If any new node has to be added, there must be some space, memory space. So if there is space only, you can add. So that can be done by checking this using this is full. Is empty is used to for when you are going to remove any data, then there must be data in order for you to remove. So this function will check whether any data is there. So that will be done by this is empty. NQ is if you want to add anything, any node, any new data into the queue, then we call NQ. DQ, it will remove a data. Then peak. Peak will print the value which is pointed by the front pointer. Then print queue, destroy queue. Destroy will destroy the whole queue. Then size queue. At any point of time, how many number of nodes in our queue. So this is how, this is our ADT. And these are all the structure which you are going to use for this queue implementation. Now let us see is full and is empty. These two functions, what they will do. Is full. Here we have declared a pointer, temporary pointer, and which is of type node. Then here we create a new node. So this node will be created. But when it creates, after creation, still it points to null. If it has created this pointer, it must be pointing to some memory location, not null. But if it is null, means there is no memory space. That is what the meaning. So it returns 1, which means there is no space. So is full will return 1. That is, it says that memory is full, so you cannot insert. It returns 1. Else, there is space. So now we will remove, delete the temporary pointer which we have created now, and return 0s, indicating that space is there. So if is full is returning a 1, that means there is no space. But if it is returning 0, there is some space. Then is empty. Here, when both the pointers are null, which means there is no node at all. There is no value, no element in the linked list. So in which case it will return Q is to be empty. So you cannot remove anything. So is empty is used to check whether the queue is having any element or not. If it is there, no element, then it is empty, will return 1. But if there is element, it returns the 0, which we are going to use it in the DQ and NQ. So now we'll see the NQ operation. NQ is nothing but inserting an element into queue. So here, let us imagine this is the queue before insertion. So these are all the values. Say some 4 values are there. Now we are going to create a new node, and the 60 is going to be added. Where we can add in a queue only at the end, which is nothing but at the rear. So how you will do? First, you have to create a node and put the data which you are going to place it in the queue. So this is placed in the data position, and this is made as null. Now this is the memory location where this is created. We assign using a temporary node we created, and the temporary node pointer is we have declared that to be a temporary variable called PTR. So here node star PTR. Here we declare a variable called pointer variable PTR, which is of type node. Then before inserting, what we have to do? We have to check whether there is any space. So that can be done by calling this function isFull. If it is returning 1, which means the queue is empty, there is no space, you cannot insert. So this will come and it will come out. Else, there is some space. When it returns 0, there is some space. So now we are ready to insert. So now you create the new node by using the operator new. Then in that space, this data location, we place this, what we pass the data. Queue, the value. Say for example, here we pass 60. So that 60 is added in this location. Then in the pointer next, we made it as null. Now this is this node is created. Now what is the next step? This has to be added to this location. Now before doing so, what we have to do? Whether you have to check whether this is the only one node. That means this is a starting node which we are going to insert. Maybe the queue is empty. The node which we are creating may be the first node. So that we have to check, or else we have to add it at the rear. So how we can check? We can check whether is empty. If empty is returning 1, which means the queue is empty, and this will be the first node. In that case, the front is made to point here. Okay. So front is made to pointer. So now after execution, the front will be pointing this. Okay, it is no more. It is not there. If imagine this is the only one node. In that case, this will be made as front as well as here. See, according to this statement. Else, now in this case, now at this condition, here we are going to add it as a last node. So this is empty is this queue is not empty. It has some value. So you have to find out the rear position and add it at the end. So now what you do, already rear is pointing this. So in rear next, in this location, we are going to write the memory location of this. So that we have done here. So in the position, in the next rear, next we write pointer. It is nothing but pointer is 200. So we have written that memory location. Now it is pointing to this node. Now these two are connected. So now rear equal to after doing that, now this becomes the rear. In the previous case also, when there is an empty thing and this is the only one node, we make both front and rear to point to this. So that is according to this we made that. So here after moving this, we made this to be a rear.